Hi, let me welcome you to teardown of Extech EX430 multimeter. Occasionally I will compare it with Extech EX330 multimeter, which was reviewed by Dave on EEVBlog. I will put the link in description, so you might want to check that video first. Go on, I'll wait. This is 4000 count multimeter with 0.3% basic DC accuracy. If user is electronic hobbyist, we can expect 0.5% plus 2 counts accuracy on all applicable DC ranges. DC current range has 1.5% plus 3 counts accuracy if you measure something under 400 milliamps. If you go higher than that, then you can count on 2.5% plus 5 counts accuracy. Interesting thing is that this multimeter has a 20 amps jack instead of more common 10 amps. This is kind of moot point because you can run it at 20 amps only for a few seconds at a time. So we can count on it as being 10 amps. Resistance range for values under 4K offers 0.8% plus few counts accuracy. Other ranges include capacitance up to 100 microfarads, frequency up to 10 MHz, and the interesting thing is that we have temperature which is separated on two ranges, one for Celsius and one for Fahrenheit. If you need to deal with AC, let's not forget that unlike EX330, this is true RMS multimeter. Multimeter came in a clamshell packaging which I had the liberty to open all alone. Inside I got reasonably sharp probes, they are rated up to 10 amps. Cable is nice, flexible, it is actually rated. Probes fit quite snugly in COM and voltage sockets. Fit in amp socket is not that good. Same goes for micro and milliamps. All included is average looking K-type temperature probe. It comes with an adapter. It's not too fancy, but it's not too bad either. Next one is a piece of fabric which can serve as a hanging strap. Instead of rare earth magnets, you basically have Velcro. And frankly, I cannot help but wonder why they bother with this. I guess somebody might find it useful, but yeah. I will not do standard test battery because I don't see point of that. I use it for a couple of days. I can assure you that everything is in spec. I will try to focus on things that are not present in user manual. First of all, let's see auto ranging speed. It's not the fastest one, but it's not really too bad. Update speed also looks fine, probably something like 2 or 3 updates per second. Continuity test. Okay, quite fast, not latched, usual. Check how it beeps at every key press. This will get quite annoying if you work during night. Let's say if you are making a video or, God forbid, you are trying to do some electronics, it will keep beeping and beeping at you. Size-wise, this is not as compact as EX330, but it's not too large either. Also, unlike EX330, this multimeter has a separate socket for milliamps and microamps. I personally prefer this setup. Display, it's nice and big if you view it at right angle. If you view it from above, it gets a bit washed out. Backlight, it has one level and it's bearable. If you place it on wooden table, can you use it? As you can see, unlike EX330, it functions just fine. Let's try out tilting bail. Sort of works, but I wouldn't count on one-handed operation while it stands on wooden desk. Range switch itself has nice positive feeling. If we get it out of holster, it has okay fit, and we give it a twist, it doesn't give at all. Quite nice. This is one of rare multimeters that has two screws for a battery compartment. Of course, no retainer. This one actually came with Duracell battery, which is quite a surprise. I was expecting Golden Power or something similar. Night wall connector is soft, but it is actually quite okay. And unfortunately, there are no fuses at sight. To open complete multimeter, we need to undo four self-tapping screws. Just to make it a bit annoying, you will notice that self-tappers come in two sizes. So you need to watch out where you put each one of them. Top ones are slightly bigger than ones on the bottom, or vice versa. Just be careful when you put them back. As you can see, it has a U channel. So it's not too deep, it has no rubber in it, but it will do. Inside we see dual board construction. Unfortunately, there are still no fuses at sight. Upper board goes into 0.1 inch header, and I don't know if you can see, but there is one more female pin than there are male. So we have six male pins and we have seven female sockets down. Maybe these extra pins are used in some other multimeter model or something like that. We simply pull it off. Okay, here we have two full metal sockets. These are for ground and for volts. And we have two split socket for amps. They go into plastic inserts, which probably combined with split socket here on amp range explains why it feels so bad. I guess that split socket was needed for input alert functionality, but frankly I would rather live without it than with all four full metal sockets. Also here you can see something that seems to be varistor. And finally we can see fuses on this additional daughter board. They are not marked at all. They are ceramic, but I wouldn't count on them being HRC. Distances between components as far as input rotation goes seem fine. There are no slots here, but it should do for CAT3. Input protection, I think that we also have one small PTC here. There is a total of seven self-tappers holding a PCB in place. PCB itself looks fine. There is no flux residue. Solder joints look okay. These two resistors are soldered a bit strange, but it will do. Somebody can correct me, but we have something that seems like two speakers here. Why would anybody do that? I'm quite positive that this one is speaker, because I could find datasheet by part number. I'm not sure what this second component is. To me it looks like speaker, but I must be mistaken, because nobody would design multimeter with two speakers, would they? Contacts seem to be gold plated, so there should be no problems with range switch. All in all, I like this multimeter. Compared to EX330, you get true RMS behavior and better accuracy. If you take into consideration that quite often you can find it on Amazon for something like $10-$20 above EX330 price, this is multimeter worth having.